What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and I'm back with another episode of Inside the Network, where we share exclusive content from inside of BrandManNetwork.com, because I signed myself, and right here, we're actually showing a snippet from an interview that I did with Nick, one of the dopest, scrappiest, most resourceful managers I've seen and enjoy to be watching coming up in the game. He works with an artist by the name of Oren Major. And before we get into this clip, because we're talking about what does a manager look like, right, in 2020, right, in today's age, I want to preface it with the fact that he lives in Arizona, his artist lives in Atlanta, and they met while living in different states online, but they've had a great relationship and really have made an impact. They're moving and grooving. Let's get into the clip.
Because we can communicate just as well almost with FaceTime, Messenger, all day, but we can live our own lives and grind separately, and then when opportunities come up, we can bring it to each other. Versus if we're hanging out, like when he visits or I visit or we're in the same place, like we're kind of just having fun, you know, like we're friends, and so we're kind of just kicking it, versus when we're separate, it's like, all right, I gotta grind, I want to make this a reality, you know. So that's kind of how that works for us.
All right, that's funny. That sounds like it's similar to what I hear people say about long distance boyfriend girlfriend relationships.
Yeah, it's like a bromance.
that's funny. Okay, well, how many tours has Oren been on so far?
Zero.
So yeah, technically, because he's done shows, but you wouldn't call them tours.
Yeah, he hasn't done any tours. So he put out his first real album or major album or whatever, January 2017. So he's only really been doing this for almost 3 years now. Once we got Spotify going, he started doing some shows, mostly opener slots, because that's, you know, how you get started. And then recently, back in March of this year, he had his first headline at the Masquerade in Atlanta. And then we decided now he's at a good point where his numbers are solid, his music is solid, let's book his first national tour. So that's going to kick off in February.
What are the dates for that tour?
Oh, man.
Not the dates. Where are some of the places?
Okay, yeah. So Atlanta, St. Louis, Houston, New Mexico, New Orleans, Phoenix, and then I think Denver, Colorado. We're also trying to add LA and Seattle and Florida. But we have seven confirmed right now.
Okay, got it. So I want to stick with this for a second. I had another question, but I got to hold it off since we're already here. Touring, how did you even determine that it's time that we can go on a tour? Starting there, how did you know? Because you said you got a feeling that y'all were there.
Right. That's a good question. It just felt right, is the main thing. So we did the show in Hawaii, right? It actually came from a connection I had made with the headliner, Greaves. So we went out to Hawaii, did that show. My family's actually out there, so we got to hang out with them. Came back, and then I think it was the first night back, we just started routing it on Google Maps just to see, like, hey, maybe we should do a tour, like we could make this work to this work, these are 8-hour drives, you know. And it was really just an idea at that point. And then mostly Oren got to work, and then 3 months later we announced it. So I don't know why we thought it was time, it just felt like time. And we know that's the best way to build up that real fan base, you know, to meet people in person, and so we're just gonna make it happen.
But how did y'all choose the cities? Because this is how many cities again?
At least seven. Okay. And we picked the city. So I talked to the booking agent at the Masquerade, and he gave us some advice on how to route a tour because he's doing tour management also. He told us Indie on the Move is a really good resource. So we contacted them. They have a program or a product or whatever that helps you to book shows. They'll help you form an EPK, all the booking materials. They'll shoot it out to everyone, and then we just kind of sift through the responses, decide which dates we want, and then kind of schedule it ourselves.
Okay, cool. All right. And, I mean, well, y'all haven't gone on that yet. So maybe, yeah. Look, know what? Afterwards, maybe we might do some kind of update or something just right. your thoughts on what it's like doing that for the first time, because y'all are doing that all together, right, the whole time?
I'm going to be there for at least half of it. It's a little tough with the full-time job, but
right.
I talked to my boss about it, and they're going to work with me to get me out there.
Cool. Yeah, that's going to be interesting. All right, yeah. All right, if you want to check out the full interview, of course, you can check it out on BrandManNetwork.com, where we also have a ton of resources when it comes to artists developing their brand and building their fan base. That can be found in the link in the description below. And other than that, if you like this video, go ahead to the like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.